Hi guys, this is Quad. Today I want to show you my setup for running Travincal on Summon Necro. Yeah, it's a little bit painful, and as a spoiler alert, this is really not the best Necro build to run Travincal. But since I am already specced as a summoner, I didn't want to change anything or go to Bone or Poison Necro. So I figured out after a couple of trial rounds how to keep the mercenary alive and what's the best way to deal with the Travincal council. Okay, and yeah, without any further introduction, let's go. So first I will show you quickly the skills. I already went through my build in a previous video, it's exactly the same. So I have the summoning tree mostly pumped up, then the maximum corpse explosion and a little bit in a bone wall just to get this bone armor to a decent level, and all the required curses with extra points into amplified damage so I don't need to cast it multiple times. Then next, my stats you can see on the screen. Again, it's just enough strength to equip the Monarch with the Spirit on it, rest into Vitality. I think I have a little bit points into Dexterity to equip Flail, Heart of the Oak. My resistances are pretty decent, and I will talk about those two, why they are not so high. And yeah, as you can imagine, running Travincal on a Summon Necro, you have to rely on your summons. But the reality is that your Skellies and Iron Golem don't deal nearly any damage to the council, so mostly all your damage is coming from the mercenary. So he is the hero here, he is the MVP, and as one guy says, AFK gaming is amazing. So let's have a look into our mercenary. So he has now whopping almost 7k damage, and it is without might. With might it gets close to 9k damage, I think, if I'm not wrong. So it's really a lot of damage. So the reason is we are having this cryptic axe obedience. You can see the top damage is almost 1000, and this is great weapon. The only downside of it is 3 to 14 cold damage, because yeah, shattered corpses don't allow us to corpse explode, so it's a bit of a bummer, but still, this damage is just amazing. He will produce so many corpses so quick. Then the main reason using the Tau Rush's death mask is because of lifesteal, life, and also extra resistances. So he gets capped resistances like this, although obedience also provides all resistances plus 30, which is amazing. But there is no other way we can get life leech anywhere else. That's why I went with the Tau's mask, provides lots of life, and in case of conviction, extra resistances are really good. And the hero of the mercenary is this Fortitude and the Hellforge plate that we just made. So again, the 300% enhanced damage is just incredibly high. You can see without it, he has only 3,500 damage, with it almost 7,000. It's just doubling the damage. This is very important. With this setup on players 1, this merc almost 1-2 shots every normal council, and about 5 shot the super uniques like Torque or Ismail. The variations, so this is what's important here. You can use Guardian Angel on your mercenary to have even more resistances against those cold, lightning, and hydras, of course. But on players 1, honestly, I found it unnecessarily. He didn't take as much damage from those. If you don't have Fortitude, Treachery is your best bet. Because of the increased attack speed, he will hit faster, so deal more damage per second. Plus, usually Fade will proc somewhere in between, so he will get damage reduction and extra resistances as well. FHR is always good. If your Iron Golem that I made out of Insight Rune Ward does not survive, then you will want to equip Insight on your mercenary. I would immediately say that Colossus Vulge here is not the best option, because 200 strength he doesn't have now, and it is almost impossible to get it without socketing, let's say, Tau's helm with extra perfect amethyst or something like that. So I would recommend again using the cryptic axe for the insight, or maybe ethereal treasure for faster attack speed. So don't do it in a Colossus Vulge, although it provides a lot of damage. Also, you probably want to roll your insight a little bit to get closer to 270 enhanced damage, and ideally 6 plus 6 to critical strike, so he deals more damage this way. Alright. Our own equip really doesn't matter so much here, so I'm using Heart of the Oak, the Monarch, then this 220 Necro Tiara. The important part is here, the Amulet of Teleportation. You can have it either on a circlet or amulet. Why is it important? Because on a swap I want to keep my Call to Arms so that I provide more health to Iron Golem and Mercenary. If you do not have Tiara or Teleport Amulet, then I would even recommend swapping out Heart of the Oak to Call to Arms, so make this your main hand, and then on a swap use the Teleport stuff, for example like this. Or I found this one that is just a little bit nicer. The reason it is important to have Teleport is, of course, to relocate your Mercenary and Summons next to one of the councils, and I will show you later how it is done. You can also run probably to the Durance of Hate and come back, but sometimes, especially on a random maps, you can get blocked. It won't be as easy as you want to imagine. Then for the rest, I'm wearing the Chance Guards just to have this extra gold, because farming Travincal you get a lot of gold. You can gamble cool stuff like this tiara, for example. Scalders for extra MF. There is nothing really that I would imagine putting here on the budget, let's say, so still extra MF is nice. And then the two saviors, the Ravenfrost with a cold absorb 20% and Dwarf Star with 15 fire absorb. That's actually the reason why I have so little cold and fire res. Hydras literally don't deal me any damage, and occasional ice novas or from the councils exploding deal a little bit less damage than they would. Sometimes, yeah, those idiots cast the blizzard on top of me, but you don't really feel it. I went with the Verdangos, but it's not really needed in my opinion, because I didn't get hit as much, so damage reduction wasn't that useful. You can instead go with some rare amulet to get more life and resistances, or gold drop, or maybe arachnid mesh to hit the 75% FCR breakpoint, and the usual regular boots with extra resistances, runwalk and MF. In the inventory, of course, Geet's Fortune, again extra gold, extra MF, really nice, and then resist, MF and other small charms. Literally you can exchange all the MF small charms for the resists, so that you have survivability and you don't feel any problems running Travincal. So most important with Travincal is to actually feel comfortable running it. For all the single player guys, I would say that running players 3 is doable, but is very annoying, because your Iron Golem tends to die really quick. Also Mercenary, the main problem if he starts hitting Stone Skin, Ismail or Torque or I don't know, somebody else, he doesn't leech much, and all the other council members heal that guy, so it is really annoying sometimes and you need to control a lot. But well, so players 1, I found it ideal. It's really super easy, smooth, and doesn't take much time. And I will show you now basically a couple of runs and the strategy on how to deal in some really bad cases. So I have two ideas there. One is a dim vision and the other one is the bone wall. Okay, let's check it out. Alright, we will start with a Flayer's jungle. I initially wanted to go to Eldritch or Shank to get the skeletons, but I figured out that swapping between acts takes too much time for loading screen, so it's really better to do just like this. And usually Flayer's jungle, we have usually a lot of flayers on the entrance, so it's kind of really neat. After that, yeah, you do your CTA cast, you can then quickly run, so you pull Hydras a little bit here, then jump in, give amplify damage, and you can see the corpses already appearing, so it's super easy. Yeah, a couple of explosions and everybody's dead. We even got the crown of thieves. That's nice. Let's check the small charm as well. Yeah, that's not bad as well. 7 fire res and 3 faster runwalk. Okay, alright, for players 1 I usually make around 5 skellies. It's usually enough to absorb the hydras and some distributed damage, so you don't really need to go overboard with 10. Alright, so the other option that you can do is either making the Dim Vision so that they don't cast Hydras anymore and also don't heal each other. This is very helpful. Or you can put a couple of Bone Walls in between so they also get distracted and start hitting those. So the whole idea here is to distribute the damage so that it's not focused on your Merc or on your Golem, so they don't die too quick. And then again, they amplify damage and you just start exploding everything and it's pretty much done. So these are the two strategies. If you're strong enough and your Merc deals a lot of damage, you can then just simply jump in, amplify damage and explode everything because corpses will be coming really quick. And if you see any difficulties with sustaining your Merc, then cast either Dim Vision or one or two Bone Walls in between so that counters start to hit it. Alright, I would say this is it. Normally these runs take me about 1 minute. If the load screens were faster, then we could make it even like maybe like 50 seconds or 45 seconds. But, well, we have what we have. So it's pretty nice to run on Players 1 and on Battle.net as well. Alright, have fun guys and thank you for watching as usually. See you next time.